Welcome to this Badminton Europe webinar. Thanks for joining us for the session today. My name is Rasmus and I'm a communication manager here at Badminton Europe. Today we will be talking about how you as a member association can use our platforms and how your content can make it to our platforms to actually also reach a broader audience. Thank you very much for joining and let's jump to it. What we're going to talk about today is first of all how you can get your content on the BEC website, how you can get it on our social media, how you can also use our streaming platform for your live streams or video on demand, how you can use the Badminton Europe app, how you can access the photo database of Badminton Europe, and finally also touching point with the Facebook cross-posting, a relatively new feature that Facebook have given us to actually also get more video content to our pages for the video purpose of ours. The first thing we will be talking about is the Badminton Europe website. How can you get your stuff on our website? It's actually not very hard. First of all, you can send us a press release. It could be about news from your organization. It could be news about your current players, your former players, your upcoming players, or whoever might be interesting in the countries of yours. It could also be around your activities. Do you have a camp? Do you have a summer school? Do you have a senior developing tournament? Do you have whatever activity you think is interesting? It might also be interesting for us. It doesn't need to be the big stars all the time. It can also be a good and great initiative that you have pulled off that could be an inspiration for somebody else around in Europe or maybe even around the world. The news section of Badminton Europe is basically an advert space for you guys. We are here to also promote the sport not only in the big events or in the BEC activities. We are also here to promote your activities and the way that you are thinking about badminton. Job adverts is another tool that can make your day maybe easier or maybe give you more applicants for whatever job that is going to be at your organization. It can be every kind of job related to badminton. In an organization, it can be a coach, it can be a national level, it can be on regional level, or it can be even on a local level. We do not care if it's a local club or if it's the new Danish national coach who's going to be advertised here. It doesn't make a difference for us as long as you guys are happy. The press releases needs to be in English. We need more than just one paragraph, two paragraphs is a minimum for us because we need also some content which we can actually publish. Photos are preferred. If you have any kind of photos, we can actually publish alongside the article. We will be very, very happy for that, especially when we're talking about activities and such, where we do not have stock photos for the articles. All can be sent to my email. You see it here on your screen. I think a lot of you already have that email too, but feel free always to send whatever you might have. Regarding the job adverts, also in English, please, in a Word format. We receive some adverts in PDF. It makes the life quite hard for us, and the format and the layout never fits the website of ours. So please send it in Word, and please attach a logo if you have a logo, which we can actually also use for the advert. Please be very clear on what's the deadline for your advertisement. Sometimes we receive job adverts where there's no deadline, so the applicants do not know when to apply for the job and if the deadline has actually passed. So please be aware that you have a very clear and clean deadline on when do you want the advert to finish. And the advert will be online in 3 months from the publication date. That's a rule that we have made because most of the adverts will not run for more than 3 months anyway. Let's take some examples on the press releases that we have received and which could be an inspiration for you guys. This is from the Netherlands. The Dutch Federation wrote this piece about launching air badminton in the Netherlands. We actually published it one-to-one. We haven't done anything about it. So that's one of the press releases that we have received lately. This one too, a memorial piece from the English Federation. Also a thing that we would be happy to also share with the community of badminton in Europe throughout our platforms. Same goes, for instance, for this. This is a statement regarding the Tokyo Olympics. I think most of you know that we have new dates for the Tokyo Olympics 2021 now. This is a statement from IOC. It could be from whoever of you guys, if you have any statement you would like to actually point out. It could also be, for instance, calendar stuff. This is an example of this. BWF announces the revamped tournament calendar for 2020. It could also be something that you could actually benefit from if you have something. Here's our tournament calendar of the year. This is our junior camp calendar of the year. Whatever purpose could be relevant. And please do not think that it needs to be a major thing to make it to our platform, because it's not. We are also a service for you guys. And if you have anything that you would like to share with the community of your in your home country, it might also be relevant for everybody else in Europe, or maybe even just your neighbor country. But this is at least a platform where you can actually benefit, maybe from actually get a broader audience. Also, this one is from the EUSA, European Universities of University Sports Association, who made this statement. Just an example. And this one again is a press release from Badminton Denmark on the player, in this case Mathias Bo, the former European champion who retired recently. But these are some of the tools or the articles, press releases that could actually be reused on our platform. So feel free to send it to us. You can find the email address on the website. I will also have it in the end of this presentation again. This is a job advert from Badminton Ireland. They are seeking a national head coach, just to give an idea of what could be an advertisement for a job. Very clean deadline, 12th of June, starting date to be August or September. There's no hesitation here when the people have to apply if they want to apply for this job. This is a local club in Norway who is looking for a head coach, also an advert displayed on our website. And again, feel free to also motivate your local clubs, your local communities around in your country to actually send you the advert to us. Deadline 21st of June. Here also pretty clear when it was. I don't know what the result was of this, but I really hope that this Norwegian club in Vestre Aker found a new coach also because of this advert. One more to finish it up. The Spanish Federation is looking for a badminton coach in high performance for the Spanish national team. This is of course a national coach, but again, it can be whatever job advert you might have. Also administrative jobs, if that's something that you're looking for. This is also a way that you can use our platform. We create a lot of content every single day, every single week, and feel free to copy paste. Feel free to use the article, the picture, whatever you need from our website. Most pictures are from Badminton Photo, which you also have access to. And if you don't, please let us know and we might be able to help you out with different photos too. This is an article about the French player Batomene, which we wrote a couple of months ago. And the French Federation asked us if they could copy paste and translate, and of course we agreed to that. There's no point for us not in sharing the information that we have and the news we have if that's beneficial for you guys. So feel free to copy paste our articles. We will of course be happy if you credit Badminton Europe for the job. That will for sure mean a lot to us. The key takeaways for the website: write in English, attach a photo and or a logo, and that's basically all you need to do. Then we will make a case-to-case decision if it goes online. I will not promise that everything goes online, but best practice has been that most things are actually online within 4 hours after we receive the content from the member association. So I really hope to see content from you guys at our platforms very, very soon. The next topic we're going to touch is how to get content on the BEC social media. One type of content that you can actually get on our social medias are photos and graphics. If you have, for instance, photos from one of your local or national activities, why not share that photos with us so we can actually share it with the rest of the European badminton community? And if you have any kind of events, feel free to send 5 photos to us and we will take a case-by-case decision if that photo goes online. Of course, it needs to fit into the bigger picture, but we are very, very keen on actually sharing your activities with the fans. It might be a big inspiration for somebody in whatever country we're actually talking about. Promotion photos of your own players might also be a good thing for us. If you had a cool photo taken for the national team of whatever country we're talking about, why not share that one with us so we can put it on our Instagram? We know that the European players have fans outside their home countries, so why not give them a little bit to enjoy the fans? And it's also a way to actually promote your players and also your federation. In terms of videos, we are always keen to share live streaming. We have a lot of live streaming opportunities within every single federation. And if you have anything, please share it with us and we will be happy to actually also share it with our fans and the followers. It could also be, for instance, a cool rally that you recorded at whatever practice it could be. It could be a junior player doing a cool shot. It could be whatever kind of rally you can actually imagine. Interviews, if they are in English, are also relevant for us. And of course, funny and cozy content. Most of you know Instagram. If it's good enough for your Instagram, it's good enough for our Instagram. So why not share and get the double amount of likes and also a reach, so the fans actually get more than they expect to get. The photos that we would actually like to see needs to be in a decent quality. It's not enough that you have an iPhone, you take a photo from 20 meters. You need to think about how the photos look. And we need no less than 5 photos for a gallery. Two photos are, unless it's a very, very nice photo, it's actually not enough. Unless we are talking about promotion pictures, because they are with a different light setting and with a different setup. Action and emotions are preferred for sure, and a written description of what is in this photo. We of course know a lot of the top players in Europe. We also know a lot of the circuit players and the junior players, but if we're talking about an activity, if we're talking about, for instance, a hobby player, senior player, we might not know who it is, and we would like to credit the people on the picture because we know it also means something for them to also see that we recognize the job that they are doing. Regarding the videos, please give us a heads up if you are planning to live stream any kind of activity, tournament, exhibition match, whatever. It gives us the chance to actually also share it with our followers. Match points, old clips, the best from the archive, these kind of content is very popular and likable. And there's no reason not to share that, in my opinion, with as many people as possible. Likable content, what is that? That's the thing that's where you stop in your feed. When you're scrolling through your Facebook, your Instagram, your TikTok, whatever platform you use, that's the likable content. And please remember a written description if you send something to us, because we would like to credit the people in the picture. And of course, you as a federation or the photographer or the videographist or whoever may make the content available for us. So the key takeaways is to be creative and also to share with as many as possible, in my opinion. If it's good enough for your platform, it's good enough for our platform. If it's good enough for your fans, it's definitely good enough for ours. And why not share it with the big community that we actually have across the continent? The next topic will be the streaming platform of Badminton Europe, www.badmintoneurope.tv, which was relaunched in the late 2019. On the platform, you will find the live streams and a video on demand. BEC will be streaming from major events and from the BEC circuit. We have a lot of archive content as video on demand, VOD. This is also a chance actually for you to tap in here. For instance, a live stream could be international tournaments not covered by Badminton Europe. If you plan to live stream, we would be more than happy to include your live stream on our platform. Of course, there is a need of quality here. An iPhone stream is basically not enough. But if you plan to live stream, please reach out to us and we can figure out how we can do things. Exhibition matches, that's one of the best examples. If you have one of your former legends or one of your current top players playing whoever, why not share it with the European fans and the fans all over the world, basically. If you have a live stream running or planning to live stream, this is a very nice add-on to the fans. Exhibition matches are mostly happening off-season, so that's actually also a gap to fill for the fans. If you would like to share this, we will be happy to share it too. Same goes for the national championships. A lot of the national championships are live-streamed. We would be happy to actually also include these in our platform. regarding video on demand, archive content, do you have a cool match from the past? Do you have a cool clip, a cool interview, whatever that could be? We would very much like to see that one. Spectacular clips, that could be a trick shot, that could be something similar to that. Exclusive interviews, as I mentioned. Do you have the final interview of your top player just the day before he retired? It might be quite cool actually for the fans to see that one. Next up is the BEC app. Most of you know Badminton Live. It has been introduced at the ADM a couple of times now. And that is an app which includes everything that communication basically has in Badminton Europe. It's articles published on the website and also not published on the website. It's photos from all the events that we have, all the BWF events, major events, and from the world tour. And of course, also from different activities. It could also be your activities if you would like to share it with us. It will be video, live streaming and on demand. And of course, live score draws, out of play results and so on. It's also included here, so maybe also a good tool for your fans actually to use this one, but also a cool platform for you to actually tap into. And the same rule goes for the app as for the website and for the social media. Please send it to us, whatever content it might be, and we will take a clear look at what could make sense. And again, I will not promise that we publish everything, but we will do our utmost to have as much as possible on the app as well as the other platforms. And of course, the player profiles. And here will encourage you to actually motivate your players to actually take a look at their player profile to also make sure it's all right, that it's okay, and that every fact there is ready. It's from the BWF database, but just to make sure that your players actually have the current profile, because that's also a way to actually promote your players. The next topic will be how you can access the BEC photo database. It's called badmintoneurope.bbego.com. Most of you know the database for sure because you have been using it for multiple events now. This is the photo database of Badminton Europe where all our photo coverage will be. It will be from the major events and the juniors under 17s, and it will be access for all member associations. All member associations already received username and password in 2019. We will resend this so to make sure that everybody is on the same page, so you can access pictures from the Badminton Europe major events. And we will make additional coverage from the European tournaments that are on the BEC circuit and hopefully also from the World Tour. We are in contact with the organizers around the circuit on how we can actually get even more photos in. And if you are an organizer, I will strongly encourage you to actually also be part of this project, because it's a way to actually not only promote the sport of badminton, but it's also a way to promote your tournament and the players attending the tournament. So if you haven't seen your mailbox already, please do so. And we'll make sure to send you also an invitation for sharing photos from your event as soon as we know how the world looks again. The final touch point for today will be Facebook cross-posting, a relatively new feature that Facebook has invited their page users to use, and which is very useful for organizations like us and like you, because that gives us a chance actually to share video content on your Facebook page. And it's a very easy tool to use, and there's actually not that many negative things to say about this tool. Badminton Europe gives you access to video content like interviews, podcasts, match highlights and relives. And you can actually share all you want as many times as you want. So if you want to share the same match every single Wednesday for the rest of the year, you can do that. If you want to share the same podcast once every week, you can do that. So it's actually an opportunity for you to get a lot of video content on your platform without actually putting a very big effort into it. So if you watch something on the Badminton Europe Facebook, please let me know if you would like to share it. We can make most things shareable. We have a cooperation with BWF, which until now do not allow us to share the BWF content with you. But all the content from Badminton Europe, from the European circuit that we are actually broadcasting and publishing on the Facebook page of Badminton Europe will be accessible for you guys. But I cannot put everything online because that's actually manual every single time. I need to go in and click. So to avoid to wasting too much time, please let me know if you see a video clip you would like to share, and then I will make it available for you. How do you use Facebook cross-posting? That's a question I get a lot, and that's why we're going to take it step by step. And I promise you, it's actually not that hard, especially not when you accept when you have accepted the invitation, which a lot of you already have. All of you should have received the invitation in your mailbox already. And if you didn't, please check again, or please come back to me. So you go to your mail and accept the invitation from Badminton Europe to cross-post. When you have done that, you open your Facebook page. We are using Badminton Europe as an example today, because that's the only one I have access to in terms of backend settings. You go to your Facebook page and you scroll down until you see this one, see videos. This one is in English. Of course, it will be different in whatever language you might speak. You choose videos to cross-post when you have pressed the see videos, and then in the Creator Studio you will find a list of all the videos that you can actually cross-post. These are the videos that BWF, for instance, gave the access to for Badminton Europe to share. And when you have found the video you would like to share, you simply just click to the left and then you press cross-post video. You can now change the title and the description. You can also keep the same if you like. We have decided here to keep the BWF title and description. You can decide to actually change the language, write whatever you like, but it's good style actually also to put in a few words in the title, so you actually help the user to actually figure out what to watch. And when you're ready, you simply just press next. And when you're ready to publish, you can go here. The top one is publish and the second one is schedule. You can either decide to publish right now, which is the top one, and then you press the blue button to in the right bottom corner here. Otherwise, you can go and schedule, and you can actually schedule it for whenever fits you. And then the blue button will turn from publish to schedule, and it is as easy as that. That's what I have for now. Thank you very much for taking your time for this BEC webinar. Please reach out if you have anything to ask. We are here to support you guys. And I would like to remind you that when we have done the exercises and the webinars, we will do a Q&A session where all of you are invited to ask whatever questions you might have, and we will try to answer as good as we can. Thank you very much for your time and have a very nice day.